Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by Mudit from California. Mudit asks, is there any way to sum just the bold cells? You know, this is a classic problem that we've had for a long time, and I try in the podcast not to go into VBA, but in this case, the solution involves just a tiny bit of VBA. I actually went out to Google and I searched for SumBold, that's one word, space UDF. UDF is a user-defined function, and there were many responses there, several of them from the old Mr. Excel message board. Here I have one from August 2001 by our friend Ivan Moala. I'm giving the function for SumBold. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually copy these characters right from the web page, Control-C. I'm going to come back to Excel. Now, if you've never gotten into the VBA before, it's very easy. We're going to go to Tools, Macro, Security. Make sure that you are at Medium. By default, you are at high, so we'll choose medium there, and then it's Alt F11 will take you to the VBA editor. To add it, your own function, you want to use Insert, Module, and I'm just going to paste Ivan's function, SumBold, right there. Now we're good. Now we can return to Microsoft Excel, File, Close and Return to Microsoft Excel, and I can now use this new function, the SumBold function, equals SumBold, and specify an area. And you'll see that it has totaled up just the bold cells with 586. Now, one interesting thing with a user-defined function is that it only gets calculated when some numeric change happens in the spreadsheet. Using bold or turning off bold is not a numeric change. So if I would actually bold a few more cells, Control-B, Control-B, and unbold this cell, in order to get the total to update, I have to hit the recalculate button, that's F9, or if I just naturally enter a number somewhere else in the spreadsheet, the spreadsheet will recalculate. So that's kind of a caution to watch out for as you bold and unbold cells. That user-defined function will not automatically update. Again, I hate to have to go to VBA on this one, but unfortunately that's the way that you have to do it. Luckily, there's plenty of examples out on the internet, including at MrExcel.com, of these types of functions that you can just copy right into your own version of VBA. One more note is this SumBold function, because I inserted it in the current workbook, is only available in this workbook. If I wanted it available on all of my workbooks, I would instead store it in a personal macro workbook. That's a story for another day, though. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.